Long blonde hair, left-handed guitarist, and was once a very respected figure in grunge music today. Kurt Cobain was born on February 20th, 1967 in Aberdeen, Washington. His parents were Wendy Fredenberg and Donald Cobain. He started singing and playing music at age 4. He also had a talent for art. Kurt's parents divorced when he was 8, and that affected his life dramatically. During his teenage years, his father would place him in the care of family and friends. While living with his friend Jesse Reed, he began to renounce Christianity and took an interest in Jainism and Buddhism. On his 14th birthday, his uncle asked if he wanted a guitar or a bicycle, and he chose a guitar. He soon started writing his own songs and convinced his friend Chris Novoselic, a bassist, to start a band with him. He named the band Nirvana based on the Buddhist belief that Nirvana is a state of which there is no pain or sadness. During his adult years, he got a job at the Polynesian Coastal Resort and moved into an apartment because his mom kicked him out. He dropped out of high school due to the fact that he didn't have enough credits to graduate, so his mom told him to get a job or leave. He also started dating Toby Vail, a founding member of the band Bikini Kill. Toby and Kurt's relationship was very deep, and they always talked about political and philosophical issues. She also inspired the song title, Smells Like Teen Spirit, by spraying Kurt Smells Like Teen Spirit on the side of his apartment. Teen Spirit was the name of a deodorant Toby wore. Later in his life, Kurt and Chris Novoselic started playing in small clubs and bars. They had a hard time with the band since it was hard to attract crowds and promote themselves around the Washington area. Eventually, the band gained some popularity and were picked up by the independent record label Sub Pop. They went through many drummers. Eventually, the band decided to settle with Chad Channing. But later on, after Nirvana's first album, Bleach, Kurt decided he didn't like Chad's style, so he decided to get a new drummer named Dave Grohl. The band gained a lot of popularity and fame, and they decided to sign to the record label DGC Records in 1990. With the release of their new album Nevermind, the single Smells Like Teen Spirit entered the mainstream, popularizing a subgenre of alternate rock called grunge. The success of Nevermind provided a numerous Seattle bands such as Alice in Chains, Pearl Jam, and Soundgarden wider audience, and as a result, alternate rock became a dominant genre on radio, music television in the United States during the early to middle 1990s. Nirvana was considered the flagship band of Generation X, and Kurt found himself reluctantly anointed by the media as a generation spokesman. Kurt's discomfort with the media attention prompted him to focus on the band's music and believing their message and artistic vision to have been misinterpreted by the public. Their third album, In Utero, challenged the band's audience and its lyrics and dramatic music videos. During a gig at the Satricon nightclub in Portland, Kurt met Courtney Love. At first, Kurt didn't want a relationship yet, but soon after, they began dating and both bonded through drug uses. On March 1st, 1994, during a tour in Germany, Kurt was diagnosed with bronchitis and severe laryngitis. He flew to Rome the next day for medical treatment and was joined by his wife on March 3rd, 1994. The next morning, Courtney awoke to find that Kurt has overdosed on a combination of champagne and Rohypnol. Kurt was immediately rushed to the hospital and spent the rest of the day unconscious. After 5 days in the hospital, Kurt was released and returned to Seattle. Courtney later stated that that was Kurt's first suicide attempt. On March 18, 1994, Courtney phoned the police telling them Kurt was going suicidal and had locked himself in a room with a gun. Police arrived and confiscated several guns and bottle pills from Kurt, who insisted that he was not going suicidal and has locked himself in a room from hiding from Courtney. On April 8, 1994, Kurt's body was found at his house by an electrician who has arrived to install a security system. Apart from a small amount of blood coming out of Kurt's ear, the electrician reported seeing no visible sign of trauma and initially believed that Kurt was asleep until he saw the shotgun pointing at his chin. A suicide note was found addressed to Kurt's childhood imaginary friend, Boda. That said, paraphrasing, "I haven't felt the excitement of listening to as well as creating music, along with really writing for too many years now. A high concentration of heroin and traces of Valium was found in his body. Kurt's body has been lying there for days. The coroner report estimated that Kurt had died on April 5th, 1994. The reason why I chose to write about Kurt Cobain is because Nirvana is an influence in today's music. Without Kurt or Nirvana, grunge music wouldn't have a good start, and it would have taken longer for the genre to popularize. His life is also very interesting to me, because I have wondered why he has committed suicide when he had all that fame. Was it the drugs, or that he couldn't handle the music scene anymore and decided to take the quick way out? But now, since I know more about him, I understand why he decided to leave this world. My name is Tian Dang, and this is a Watertown High School media production.